Hello! Today we're going to be building some rubber band blasters and two targets. I hope you guys are ready to have a blast. Alright, first grab the handle piece with the blue foam, then flip it over. Use two green bolts and insert them up through the bottom. Then attach two blue spacers to the tops of those bolts. Next, let's add another green bolt and blue spacer to this hole over here. Next, grab the blue front hook and place it right in these three pegs. It should line up with the edge of the wood. Then secure into place with a green bolt. Looks like that from one side and this from the other. Next, let's attach the right trigger. It'll be the piece with the little R on it. Place it like so on this top bolt, and it should be able to spin like this. Next, grab an O-ring and connect the spacer to this little dowel right here. Next, grab a peg wheel and put it on this spacer. Make sure that the flat side of the peg wheel is touching the flat side of this little ratchet. Next, grab this blue painted piece and then flip it over to sandwich everything you've just assembled. Secure into place with a green bolt. And attach the rest down with the blue bolts. We built one of the handles. Next, find the handle piece with the red foam and flip it over. We're gonna do the same thing here and attach three green bolts up through the bottom and secure them on with three spacers. Next, we're gonna attach another hook. And again, make sure this top point is facing up. Secure into place with a green bolt. Next, find your left trigger and place it on this spacer right here. Use another O-ring to secure the trigger to this spacer. Next, we're going to find the other peg wheel, and again, make sure that the correct letter is facing up, so we want the L to be facing up. Slide it on this peg, and just double check that the flat edge of the peg wheel is against the flat edge of the trigger. Then grab this yellow piece of wood and flip it over to sandwich everything inside. Secure it down with the green bolt up here. And use three blue bolts to secure the rest of it. Awesome, you've built the other blaster. All right, now to load it up. Take one rubber band, stretch it around the hook on the top, and then stretch it over this lowest peg. To load the next one, rotate it manually and do the exact same thing again. So over the top hook and then over the lowest peg. And then keep doing that until you've loaded all five. Awesome, so now I've loaded up all my rubber bands. So time to load up the other blaster. We're gonna do this one the exact same way, where we start with the hook, we stretch it down to the lowest peg, and then manually rotate it once before loading on the next. And then once you see that that top one is loaded, you're ready to start firing. To put these blasters together, you can attach it to the base. So these blue bolts on the backside can notch into these holes. All right, now that we've built our blaster, let's go over how to use it. So hold it just like a video game controller and then use your index finger to press these triggers. So if you press it pretty quick, then you should launch one at a time. You can also hold them side by side, just like this, dual wield. But just make sure to hold it in the same way. If you try to hold it like this, then the wheel's gonna pinch your hand and it's not gonna be very fun. So, much more accurate, much cooler, hold it like this. Also make sure not to point them at your eyes, your friends, or your pets, because it's not cool, might hurt. All right, now time for some troubleshooting. If you press the trigger and too many rubber bands launch at once, make sure you only have one rubber band loaded per peg and that you press the trigger really quickly. If your peg wheel won't turn, or if your trigger feels floppy and isn't doing anything, then let's go ahead and open it up. Let's see what's going on with this peg wheel. So when you stretch a rubber band on, the flat edge should be against this blue piece. And when you slide it up, it's able to move forward one. That's called a ratchet. So in order for this ratchet to work, you need the flat sides touching each other, just like that. If you try loading some rubber bands on and they just fly off, then you need to make sure that this piece is secured to a spacer. So double check that your O-ring goes over the spacer and over this peg right here. That way, when you load on a rubber band, it holds in place until you press the trigger. Find this blue piece and line up this little hole with this slot down here. To secure it into place, attach it with a green bolt. Perfect. Next, grab a target frame and insert one end into this light blue clip. It might need a little bit of extra muscle, but don't be afraid to ask a grown-up for help. Then take the other end of your frame and wrap it all the way around and insert it into the other side. All right, next, let's repeat this step and build a second one. Next, grab a target and two target clips and attach them together. Perfect. Then, to install them into the frame, push in one side and then the other. Make sure the target can spin. If the paper rubs on the plastic ring, take it out and push on the plastic to make a more perfect circle. Then, pop it back in. Next, let's build a vertical target. So we're gonna attach the target clips again. And we're gonna go ahead and slot these in right here. First one side, and then the other. All right, now that we've finished our targets, let's play. So slide these out to somewhere that's a little bit far away to do your target practice. And pro tip, if you want your targets to spin super well, aim for the outside edges. Like, it's way easier to spin something if you hit it on the side versus if you hit it on the center. It kind of doesn't work as well. And see if I can get. Yeah! And see if I can get this one. And if you want to keep the fun going, you can make your own custom targets and do your own pixel art with either the topper or your custom spinning target. Did you know that your rubber band blaster is actually powered by two types of energies? The first one is potential energy. So potential energy is when there's a bunch of potential for a bunch of energy to get released. So basically, if you stretch this rubber band, you're loading it up with a ton of energy. Yeah. So if you stretch it between two hooks, then that energy can't go anywhere. And so it's just loaded with a bunch of potential energy. When you pull the trigger, all that energy that you loaded into it with your muscles gets released and it turns into kinetic energy. So that's when all that potential energy gets put into motion. Kinetic basically just means moving. Isn't that cool? And that's how your rubber band blaster is harnessing physics to power itself. Thank you so much for building with us today. I hope you guys had a blast too. And if you want to see more stuff like this, subscribe to our channel. See you next time. Ah! okay. Yeah, I'm like, don't put it at your eyes.
Let's give it a shot. Give it a shot as a pun, because it's a blaster.